Well, here's something we can definitely say can't say too often these days. PM Julia Gillard was nowhere to be seen today. Perhaps she was poring over all that paperwork back in the office, or, dare we say it, maybe just putting her feet up. Not so the Duracell bunny of Australian politics, Tony Abbott. Our man in Canberra, Hugh Ribbenton, has been taking a closer look at the opposition leader's strategy for an election that's still probably 2 years off.
Votes. You can get them riding, you can get them frying, you can get them down on the farm. Tony Abbott has a hard-earned thirst for the election win that so narrowly eluded him last time.
I'm going somewhere.
And even his political enemies admit there's a little bit of sheer genius.
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
You have to admit Abbott's shown a lot of discipline. It's a very difficult strategy.
As media advisor to former Prime Minister Kevin Rudd, Lachlan Harris knows the game.
You have to give credit where credit's due. It's an effective media strategy if your aim is to keep the issue just on one issue, which is a carbon tax.
It wasn't always like that. Labor was delighted when Tony Abbott seized the leadership from Malcolm Turnbull, remembering his blundering in the 2007 election when he mocked the dying asbestos campaigner Bernie Banton and swore at Nicola Roxon.
That's bullshit.
Labor has stopped laughing. The renowned fitness fanatic ran non-stop for the last 36 hours of last year's election campaign. He almost won the crowd. Now he is on permanent campaign, crisscrossing the country, burning energy at a rate few people can match. Part of his game, minimise the losses.
The statements that need to be taken absolutely as gospel truth is those carefully prepared, scripted remarks.
After tying himself in knots on the serious political interview programmes in his first year, he now avoids them. On the road, he shuts down the media once his main points are out.
We'll do a doorstop later on, eh?
Yeah.
Because I'll have a chat to Cam about that.
But just your own opinion. Yeah.
No, what about the country? Later.
The techniques might annoy a few reporters, but the public rarely sees it, and the system works for him.
Yes, so we'll go here and we'll come to the front and then come back, yes.
The Prime Minister tends to stand until all questions are exhausted. Journos love it. It transmits the power to them. Both political leaders know the value of getting out to work sites where real Australians earn a living, but only Tony Abbott gets down on the tools. For a Sydney North Shore monarchist, a man who argued for work choices, Tony Abbott is comfortable with working men. And worryingly for the government, they seem comfortable with him. Almost throughout his time in office, John Howard was able to use one of the great strengths of being Prime Minister, the ability to change the agenda if he started losing the argument. John Howard's former Chief of Staff, Graham Morris, says Tony Abbott's mastery of pictures and imagery means he is driving much of the national agenda, depriving the Prime Minister of at least part of her power. Where Labor's Kim Beazley lamented the difficulties in getting notice from opposition, Tony Abbott forces himself onto the nightly news, until some seem confused over who the real Prime Minister is.
Mr. Abbott.
Labor hopes even if Tony Abbott is inexhaustible, the voters will tire of him.
Every strategy has a point of diminishing returns, and I think he's starting to reach that. When the strategy is the story, the strategy is no longer working.
But maybe that's just a spin doctor spinning.